video, we will discuss the pathophysiology of cystic fibrosis. The objectives of this video are to explain the physiology of cystic fibrosis, relate complications to the disease process, and identify symptoms of it. Cystic fibrosis is a genetic disorder. Both parents need to be carriers of the gene to have a child with CF. About 1 in every 31 Americans is a symptomless carrier of the defective gene. The mutated gene of cystic fibrosis results in thick mucus secretions in the exocrine ducts. It affects every organ in the body, but the biggest effects are on the lungs and pancreas. Thick secretions block the airway in lungs, interfering with breathing. In the GI system, the small ducts connecting the pancreas and liver to the small intestine are blocked, inhibiting bile and digestive enzymes from reaching food. Without digestion, nutrients from food cannot be absorbed. In the sweat glands, excess sodium is secreted through sweat. Due to the condition of cystic fibrosis, the body has to work harder to accomplish normal processes. This hypermetabolism requires a lot more calories be ingested through food. But without bile and digestive enzymes, the food is never able to be absorbed. Malabsorption is common and leads to reduced calorie intake and nutrient deficiencies that affect growth and weight. The blockage of flow from the pancreas can cause pancreatitis and activation of pancreatic beta cells, interfering with insulin production. But the most deadly complication in cystic fibrosis is with breathing and risk of respiratory infections. Symptoms can vary somewhat based on the age and degree of disease severity. It typically presents with coughing, wheezing, and respiratory infections due to problems with the lungs. Weight gain may be difficult due to the malabsorption that causes diarrhea and steatorrhea. In turn, poor nutrient absorption can lead to poor growth in kids. So much salt is excreted in sweat that one can taste it. This is often how parents first notice something is wrong in their child. It is called the kiss test. When parents kiss their child's forehead, they can taste the excess salt. Unfortunately, there is no cure for this inborn error. The average life expectancy is 37 and a half years. Respiratory therapy, medications, and diet therapy are critical to the treatment plan. As you look at the pathophysiology of this condition, you should be thinking about how this will translate to diet therapy to prevent malnutrition, promote growth in children, and improve longevity.